similar to acid, we can determine the chemical type of phenol by using different reagents. Let's say the phenol such as the alpha naphthols or beta naphthol or different phenols are present in the test tube. So in the first step, we can add the 10% NaOH into this test tube. When we are adding 10% NaOH, at that time this phenol will get dissolved into NaOH solution and will get the clear solution in the test tube. This indicates that the phenol is present in the test tube, and that can be confirmed by adding 1:1 HCl into the test tube, or we can use few drops of concentrated HCl. By adding concentrated HCl or the 1:1 HCl, again the formation of precipitate takes place, and this indicates or this confirms the presence of phenol in the test tube. While doing all these tests, at that time we must know the chemistry behind this particular test. So let's say the initial compound is phenol. Here I am taking a general compound like phenol, and in this phenol, in the first step we are adding the NaOH solution. So I will write it as NaOH. Here in NaOH you can write the charge separation. So just pause the video and try to write down the charge separation on this phenol as well as the NaOH. Here you can see that on nitrogen we have delta positive charge, and on this OH we have delta negative charge. Similarly, on this oxygen we have negative lone pair of electrons, and this lone pair of electrons will attack on this sodium. It means that in the next step we get sodium phenoxide ion. So let me write. Now here we mention that in test 2 we have clear solution. It means that this sodium phenoxide ion is soluble or water soluble. So I will use the same color. So here I will use the same color for sodium. So we can write the charges delta negative as well as delta positive on this sodium, and generally this is known as sodium phenoxide ion. Here you can see that this clear solution is nothing but the sodium phenoxide ion plus water molecule. And in the next step, again we are adding the HCl into this test tube. So while adding the HCl, at that time you can see that this negatively charged oxygen will attack on the H plus. Here we can see that hydrogen carries delta positive charge as well as chlorine carries delta negative charge. It means that in the last step we already mentioned that there is formation of precipitate takes place. It indicates whatever original phenol is present in the test tube, that phenol is regenerated, and that's why we get the precipitate of that phenol. Plus simultaneously we get the sodium chloride as a side product.